Dear students, today we are going to study about the mechanism of action of hormones. You know that the hormones are secreted by the endocrine glands, and the hormones are carried by the blood to the distantly located target organs. And the target organs or the target cells, they are capable of responding to the hormones because they have certain receptors which can bind with these hormones. So the receptor proteins, they are present either on the surface of the plasma membrane of the target cells, or they are present in the cytoplasm, in the interior of the cell. And these hormones, they bind with the receptors, and the binding of the hormones with these receptors will bring about a change in the configuration of the receptors. And this change is bringing about the change or the response within the cell. The hormone receptor interaction is highly specific. That is, each hormone is having a specific receptor, and only the receptors which are specific for a hormone can bind with the with that hormone. The other receptors cannot bind with the hormone. So the hormone receptor interaction is highly specific. I hope you understood. Each hormone is having a specific receptor, and a hormone can bind only with its own receptor. It cannot bind with any other receptor. So likewise, a receptor can receive or bind with only its own hormone. It cannot bind with other hormones. So the hormone receptor interaction is highly specific, and only the target cells or the target organs which are having a receptor specific for a hormone, only those organs or those cells can respond to the hormones. For example, the hormone LH and FSH, they are having the reaction on the ovaries. So the ovarian follicles, they are having the receptors for this FSH and LH. The other cells in the body, they are not having receptors for FSH and LH. So the other cells in the body, they are not responding to the action of FSH and LH, whereas the ovarian cells with the receptors for FSH and LH, only those cells, only those ovarian cells are capable of responding to FSH and LH. I hope now it is more clear for you. Now let us see the mechanism of action of hormones. You know that there are protein hormones and steroid hormones, and these hormones, they have different mechanisms of action. The steroid hormones, they are lipid soluble. The hormones are carried by the blood, and when they reach the target organ, they diffuse from the blood capillary, and they through simple diffusion, they diffuse through the plasma membrane. This is the plasma membrane. So, through simple diffusion, they diffuse through the plasma membrane of the target cell. You know that the steroid hormones are lipid soluble, and the plasma membrane of the cell is made up of phospholipid bilayer. And since the steroid hormones are lipid soluble, they can enter into the cell through the plasma membrane by simple diffusion. And these the receptors for the steroid hormones are located in the cytoplasm of the cell. Since the hormones can diffuse through the plasma membrane, they have intracellular receptors. The receptors are located in the cytoplasm of the target cell. And when the hormone enters into the cytoplasm of the cell, they bind with the cytoplasmic receptors and form the hormone receptor complex. And these hormone receptor complexes, they are transcription factors. Transcription factors, we say the molecules as transcription factors when they are capable of binding with the DNA. So the transcription factors are those factors which are capable of binding with DNA. So here you can see the hormone receptor complex. They are entering into the nucleus. This is the nuclear membrane. This is the nuclear pore. Through the nuclear pore, the hormone receptor complex is entering into the nucleus from the cytoplasm. And inside the nucleus, the hormone receptor complex is binding with the DNA. So this is the DNA. The hormone receptor complex is binding with the DNA. That is where they are said to be transcription factors. And what is transcription? Transcription is the synthesis of mRNA from the DNA template. That is that process is called transcription. So transcription is the synthesis of mRNA from DNA template. So the hormone receptor complex is binding with the DNA, and this binding will cause the transcription of mRNA from DNA. So here you can see a new mRNA is synthesized from the DNA template, and this mRNA or the messenger RNA is then transported from the nucleus to the cytoplasm. And in the cytoplasm, the mRNA is undergoing translation process. I hope you have learned about this transcription and translation processes during your previous classes, that is during your plus two classes. You might have heard about this transcription and translation processes. So I will just briefly mention about this. Transcription is the synthesis of mRNA, and this transcription takes place inside the nucleus, and the sequence of nucleotides in the mRNA is actually copied from the sequence of nucleotides in the DNA. So that process of synthesis of mRNA from the DNA template is called transcription. And this mRNA is actually, why it is called messenger RNA? It is called messenger RNA because it is actually carrying the information about the sequence of amino acids in the proteins that is to be synthesized. And this information is stored in the DNA, and mRNA is carrying that, is copying that information and carrying the information to the cytoplasm. And the, when the mRNA reaches the cytoplasm, it will bind with ribosomes. Here you can see the ribosomes. The ribosomes will bind with the mRNA, and this mRNA is translated into protein. Here you can see the protein. The bead-like structures which are present in the protein, they are actually the amino acids. So the amino acids are aligned according to the sequence, and they took the form what is called the protein. And this formation of protein based on the RNA template, that is called translation. So this protein that is synthesized inside the cell will bring about the changes inside the cell, which are actually the basic reason for all these changes is the entrance of the hormone into the target cell. So that is the action of steroid hormones. So the steroid hormones, they are lipid soluble, and they are since they are lipid soluble, they can diffuse through the plasma membrane, and they have intracellular receptors. They bind with the intracellular receptors and form the hormone receptor complex. Hormone receptor complex is entering into the nucleus and binding with the DNA, and DNA undergoes transcription and produce mRNA, and mRNA is carried to the cytoplasm. mRNA will bind with ribosomes, and translation occurs, and the protein is synthesized, and this protein will bring about the changes within the cell. So that is the action of steroid hormones. Now let us see the action of protein hormones. Protein hormones, they are not lipid soluble. Protein hormones are water soluble. They are not fat soluble, or they are not lipid soluble. So they cannot enter into the cytoplasm of the cell. So they cannot diffuse through the cytoplasm. They cannot diffuse through the plasma membrane of the cell. And so the protein hormones cannot enter into the cytoplasm of the cell. Here you can see the protein hormones, they are also carried by the blood, and when they reach the target organ, they bind with the extracellular or the plasma membrane bound receptors. The protein hormones, since they are not lipid soluble, they cannot enter into the cell. So they have the receptors on the surface of the plasma membrane of the target cell. So the receptors are located on the surface of the plasma membrane of the target cell, and the hormone is binding with these receptors, and these receptors, they have a G protein on the cytoplasmic side. On the cytoplasmic side of the receptors, they have a G protein, and the binding of the hormone with this receptor will activate the G protein. And this activated G protein will now activate another transmembrane, another membrane bound enzyme, which is called adenylyl cyclase. So the activated G protein will activate adenylyl cyclase, and this adenylyl cyclase is an enzyme which synthesizes cyclic AMP from ATP. ATP is adenosine triphosphate, and this ATP is converted to cyclic AMP or adenosine, cyclic adenosine monophosphate by the enzyme adenylyl cyclase. And this cyclic AMP is acting like the second messenger. So which was the first messenger? The first messenger was the hormone. So hormone is the first messenger, and since the hormone, the protein hormone, cannot enter into the cytoplasm of the cell, the information is transferred and a second messenger is synthesized inside the cell, that is the cyclic AMP, and the cyclic AMP will now activate protein kinases. Here you can see this is the inactive protein kinase. It is converted to the activated protein kinase by the cyclic AMP, and this cyclic AMP will now activate other proteins within the cell by phosphorylation. Phosphorylation is addition of phosphate molecules, and these phosphate molecules are obtained by the breaking down of ATP into ADP. Here you can see ATP is broken down to ADP. Here there are three phosphate molecules, and it is converted to ADP with two phosphate molecules, and the third phosphate molecule is released here, and it is binding with the protein, and here this protein is phosphorylated with a phosphate group bound to it here, and this phosphorylated protein is now active, and this phosphorylated protein will now bring about the changes within the cell. So that is how the protein hormones are acting. The protein hormones, they are having membrane bound receptors. The membrane bound receptors, when they are bound with the hormones, the G protein on the intracellular side or the cytoplasmic side will get activated. The G protein is activating adenylyl cyclase. Adenylyl cyclase is now converting ATP to cyclic AMP. Cyclic AMP is the second messenger, and the cyclic AMP will now activate protein kinases, and the protein kinases will now cause the activation of inactive proteins in the cytoplasm by phosphorylation, and the phosphorylated proteins are now active, and they bring about the metabolic changes within the cell. So that is about the mechanism of action of protein hormones. Thank you.